Hello friends, today I will tell you about the function of money creation by commercial banks. First column shows round, second column shows deposit in rupees, third column shows cash reserve in rupees, and fourth column shows loan in rupees. Suppose the commercial bank receive the initial deposit of rupees 1000 and legal reserve ratio LRR is 10%. Now the commercial bank can only keep 100 rupees with them and the remaining amount they will give as loan. Like this process will continue. In next round we will do 10% of first round shows 900 deposit because the person who receives the loan of rupees 900 will give this amount to the lender, okay? And the lender will deposit this rupees 900 in his or her bank account, so the deposit will be of rupees 900. Then again we will do 10% of 900. It will be 90. Again the commercial bank will lend rupees 810. Now the lender will receive this amount and he will again deposit this amount in her or his bank account. Now we will do 10% of 81. It will be 81 and the remaining amount will be 729. So the lender will again receive rupees 729. Like this function will continue and the total will be of rupees 10,000. Cash reserve will be 1,000 and loan will be rupees 9,000. So if we sum up the loan and cash reserve, we will get the sum equal to rupees 10,000. Okay. Now I will tell you about how to calculate money multiplier. Money multiplier is equal to 1 upon legal reserve ratio is equal to 1 upon 0.1 because I have already told you that legal reserve ratio was 10%, so 10 upon 100 is equal to 0.1. Then money multiplier is equal to 10 and the total deposit will be of rupees 10,000. I can prove it. Money multiplier is equal to 10 into cash reserve. The cash reserve was of rupees 1,000. So we get deposit equal to rupees 10,000. This is the complete process of calculating money creation by commercial banks. Thank you. If you like my video, please subscribe it.